All right. Pull up your socks. Roll up your sleeves. It's time to get active with Radioactive. 90.4 megahertz. Get active. Get
active! Hello, friends. You are listening to Radioactive 90.4, Bangalore's first community radio station. I am Santosh, hosting a new series on STEM education. Last week, we heard from QtPi team members about the need of STEM education. Today, we shall talk to nice, intelligent, and super children. And first, we have Mr. Harshil Nair from Christ Academy, who is in fourth grade. Harshil, welcome.
Thank you.
And next, nice, intelligent, and a super child we have is Hasvika, yes, from Harvest International School, fourth grade.
Thank you.
And the third, we have a very interesting boy who is Neel Angadi. He is also from Harvest International School, fourth grade. Welcome you.
Thank you.
Welcome you all.
Thank you.
Thank you again.
Today we will chat on how robotics is helping them. We'll look into the robotics aspect of children enjoying and learning through that.
Hello dear people, my name is Hasvika. I'm from Harvest International School, grade 4A. I'm going to talk about QtPi Robotics. I love to eat a lot of healthy vegetables, salads and stuff. I like to play football. Thank you.
Wow, she is interested in being foodie. She likes playing football and then she also likes robotics.
Yep.
Wow, very great. So I request now Harshil Nair to tell about himself.
Hello everyone, my name is Harshil. I'm studying in Christ Academy, 4th A. I am going to talk about robotics and my favorite sport is cricket. My favorite player in sports is Sachin Tendulkar.
Wow, you also like to become a Sachin Tendulkar?
Yes.
Wow, great. So now I request Neel Angadi to introduce himself.
Hello everyone, my name is Neel. I am studying in Harvest International School 4E. I am going to say about robotics today. Robotics helps others to do their works easily. I like to play football. Thank you.
Wow, so you want to solve some problems, right?
Yes.
Using doing that. Okay, so let us begin our small chat. From 10 years from now, what you would like to invent?
Answer.
Oh wow, okay. Anybody else after that?
Yes.
Okay, first let's go to Hasvika.
Okay, after 10 years, suppose there's a machine. I want a machine like, okay, I go to it. For my breakfast, I want pizza. There will be a voice device in it. I will ask it. Okay, machine, hello. I want pizza today for breakfast. Then just a 1 second break and I will get my pizza for breakfast. That's what I want.
Oh, that's going to be the quickest robot you're going to have in the world to give you pizza. And yeah. That is an amazing idea. Great. Yeah, now can we ask Harshil to tell his view on what you want to do after 10 years, Harshil?
I would like to invent some common man user-friendly robots that can help in farming and rescuing in operations.
Wow, what kind of operations is it? Any idea?
Yeah, some type of surgeries.
Oh, okay. So you want to help the doctors, is that so?
Yes.
Wow, wonderful. This is interesting. Okay, now we have Neel, who will share his idea of what he would like to do after 10 years from now.
I would like to make a robot which helps me doing all things such as doing my homework and classwork.
Okay, homework, interesting. Okay, we're going to have a robot which will do homework. Okay, so you all enjoy robotics, right?
Yeah, we love it.
Okay, now if you had a robotics kit with you now, what would you build and why?
I
want
to answer this.
Oh, okay. I heard Neel this time first. Can I go with Neel?
Yeah.
If you're okay. Okay, and then I'll come to Harshil. No, Hasvika and then Harshil. Is that okay? Yeah, yes.
I would like to make a house which can take some things which can be smaller than me or small, like ants and all.
Wow.
For ants' house.
Oh, you want to create an ant's house?
Yeah.
That's interesting. Okay. Any idea how will you do that?
I would take 45 degree blocks and make some kinds of mountain things and a hole for it and then finished.
Okay, you're going to make a like a foolproof house.
Yes.
So in rainy season, any season, you're probably able to have a house for an ant. Oh, that's interesting. Hasvika, over to you.
I would make an RC car, put my dolls in it and make it right here and there.
Okay.
So that I can play with it. Whenever I get bored, I play with my Barbie dolls and then I have to make a car out of paper. But if I have a QtPi Robotics kit, then it's very easy. I can just build an RC car and make it right here and there.
Wow. So any other idea which you have on that?
That's it.
Okay, that you would like to do. Yes, Nair.
I would like to build a drone because it's fun to play with.
Wow. Okay. Well, what will you do with the drone?
I'll fly it.
Oh, you'll fly it. And do you like to do when it flies something in the sky?
Yeah, I can fit some type of LEDs with it. And
okay. Uh-huh.
At the night, I can make like it glow. It glows.
Oh, okay. This is interesting. Okay, you want to clap for it? Okay, all three are really good. Okay, you had amazing, great ideas.
It's more gooder than mine.
It's better.
Okay, no, that's okay. You have your own ideas. There, he's his own idea. That's nice. So, we appreciate it. Okay, I have some mathematical question for you. You like mathematics, right?
Yeah.
Very simple mathematics.
I love it.
Oh, you love it?
Yes.
Your math was...
Because my grandpa loves math. My dad loves math, so we mm-hmm. are step-by-step mathematics.
Even I love math, but till only 12th standard, not after that.
Why?
Don't ask me why, okay. Okay, if you have to measure the space of this room, okay, what are the ways would you like to measure this room?
I would answer the standard.
Okay, first she, second you, maybe Neel if you want. You like mathematics, okay, let's see.
But
if
still,
you can.
I don't know how to measure. I thought to do.
Okay, let's see. Maybe you can listen to them, maybe you can think of it.
Okay.
Okay, let's see.
I will put one by one all my toys in a line mm-hmm. for like a plus and measure the width and the like length of the room.
Oh, could you tell us that again? Would like interesting.
I would put all my toys in a line,
okay.
Like from there to there.
Okay.
Then from the
so
length.
So what do you get here?
Width.
You get a length, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Length and a width.
Okay, then what do you do?
Then after that, I can count my toys. Okay, and then I'll measure my toys. Then I can add it and I'll do it.
Okay, do you have any formula for it?
Formula? Yeah, I can multiply.
Oh, good. Yeah, that's it. Yeah. How about you, Harshil?
First way I would like to measure my room is I can fix a measuring tape with an RC car and ride it.
Mm-hmm.
And I can measure the room. And the second way is using an ultrasonic sensor.
Okay.
And in the programming, I can choose an option that the label option and in the phone, it can show me the distance.
Wow, this is a lot of technology work, no? I
yeah,
like the way
I
both of you.
Wait.
Okay, that's different. Neel, you have any answer for this?
No, I don't.
No problem. Okay, fine. Okay. Next, I have an interesting question for all of you. Okay.
Okay.
Do you like animals?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Do you like animals which are in the water?
Yeah.
Okay. Fish?
Fish I like, except frog. I don't like frog.
Okay. Fish you like, all of you? You
yeah.
like seeing fish at least in the pond or in the water
yeah,
body?
Yeah, I love
okay.
fish.
Now, if a fish has to live on the land, do you think it is possible?
No.
Yes, yes,
no,
yes,
never,
yes,
never,
yes.
never.
Okay,
yes.
never. Okay, why do you think it is never?
Because it never can't live. The water is something where fishes can live, but where land is there, they can't live.
Okay.
Any fishes.
What if they can breathe in land?
They can't
they
breathe
can.
In land. How will
some
they?
Of the fishes will breathe. Yeah.
Okay. We have somebody saying it can live. So let us listen to.
There are already two fishes, mudskipper and lungfishes, that live on land.
Wow. Oh. I did not know.
I don't
okay.
want fishes to live on land because like suppose we are riding the car. I love pets. So
mm-hmm.
suppose I'll feel really guilty if the fish comes under the car and it's dead.
Oh,
so
okay.
I don't want that to happen. Please.
Okay,
God.
Maybe the fish live in forest, I think. So someplace above the tree or something.
Yeah,
then
mangrove
that's
forest.
Okay.
They live in mudskippers live in mangrove forests.
Wow, okay.
But I don't want them to come on under my car or something bad happening or it's dead or this happens, that happens.
Yeah.
I would start crying on the floor.
Oh.
Even me.
Yeah, okay.
Sorry.
That's interesting. So we also have some animals like a fish which stays on the land. Okay. Next is, okay, let's go to some other animals. So have you seen lizard in the house?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yes.
I have seen.
Yes.
times
I
in my
hate
o-
lizards.
Old house.
I hate lizards. They're so sticky.
Okay, can you tell me what is the shape, size, and color of it?
I would like to answer it.
okay.
It the shapes and size of the lizard will vary varies every times and
It's not green in color.
Yuck. It's
not green. It's okay, you don't like round. It, but just it is also like us, right? It's
it
leaving.
It can be sap green or, you know, it can be brown, not dark brown. Sap green is a different color.
I didn't say dark
brown.
Okay, anything. It's okay. They have a conical shaped face, a flat body, and a slender tail.
Oh, he has a lot of mathematics and
no,
science.
No, it's not a cylinder. It's like a stick.
Yeah, okay. It's like a stick, flatted stick.
Yeah, yeah, I agree with both all of you. Yeah.
And
yeah.
At the last, there is a full point.
Oh, good.
Yeah, it looks like a needle.
Oh, you have great observation, all of three of you. We are amazing.
Any in our garden.
Okay, I understand you, all of you have built some robots, right?
Yeah. Yes.
Okay, and how many robots have you built?
We have built that. I need to start thinking and start counting.
Maybe
so we have built a basketball counter, RC car, light follower. Then there was a Rubik's Cube one. I forgot its name.
No problem.
I know. Rubik's Cube's house.
No, it's safety. Rubik's Cube safety.
Oh,
I got it.
What have you built, Harshil?
I have built few robots like.
Mm-hmm.
Obstacle avoider, RC car, smart tap, smart scrubber, and I've made my own project, that's smart water scrubber.
Wow! Can you tell us more about it?
So when the IR sensor detects something, then the DC motor spins, even the pump motor pumps water.
Wow! Okay, that's interesting. Can one of you explain me the full project, the way you design?
I know the blocks. I can tell the different kind of blocks.
Okay, maybe you can add on. Okay, let's see.
I know. If we need to make a RC car, we need two wheels and a caster wheel.
Plus a DC motor.
Two DC motors. And we need blocks such as 5-hole pillar,
45-degree
block, T-joint.
I-block.
I-block, then L-block.
Yeah.
Okay, so you use the different building blocks to make a structure.
That's okay. Six blocks.
Yeah.
And the main part is the motherboard.
Okay, yeah. What does motherboard does in the
it
robotics?
It actually activates the whole thing.
Oh.
And
wow.
It helps to connect with Bluetooth
client.
In the phone. Bluetooth wow. Client and it can even connect to IR sensors or...
Yeah.
Okay. So, how was your feeling for the first time when you built a robot?
We were like, wow, there's something on Earth like this.
Okay.
It was very nice. Okay. I felt instead of buying and playing with something, I felt very nice for making and playing with something.
Okay.
Like
so
it's
you're...
our own hard work, so we feel very good at the end playing with it.
I was proud of my team.
Wow. So, it is something like why to buy a robot when you can build your own robot? Something like that, right? Yeah, okay. Can some of you tell me, what did you learn by doing all this?
I can tell.
Okay, let me start with him and Hasvika later.
And then you. Is that okay, Neel?
Okay.
I learned about different sensors and motors, and I learned how to program the motherboards.
Wow, great. So, when you say motherboard, it is heart of the robotics, right? Okay, cool. Nice. Hasvika?
Yeah, it's like it helps you to learn technologies and, you know, all the science stuff.
Wow.
And it helps you, like, increase your knowledge.
Wow. So, anything you want to specifically you like and remember?
Yeah, I like the, you know, you can tell the basketball counter. It's like we could throw the ball from far and try. We could actually play like we are playing basketball.
Oh, you had a fun also building and then having fun.
Yeah.
Wow, great. Yes, Neel?
I learned confidence. Anything we can plan, we can do it.
Wow. Okay, good. If you want to build a robot to solve a problem, what kind of robot do you like to build?
I would like to tell. I will build a, like, you know, a normal robot. Like if you tell, okay, if I spill coffee on the floor, I'm like, robot, I need get a cloth and clean it. Then I won't get scolding from my mom. And I don't even need to clean it. Then my robot will do it on my own.
So you spill a lot of on the floor of coffee. I see. Yeah. Okay. Harshil.
If there is a problem like in a bike or something, so I can use a robot that helps to make punctures proper.
Wow. So, yeah, there's a lot of time we go on the highway or on the road and you see vehicles get punctured.
Yes.
And you feel there should be a robot automatic to carry and then it gets fix your puncture. This is amazing idea. Are you planning to work on this? Are you planning to think something to do on this? Yeah, good, great. Neel.
I would like to do a robot which can be a mechanic for me if anything anything broke, something like car tires,
that was a glass thing broke,
glass and all. I can use it for example, if any glass broke, I'll say robot automatically go and take a glass
automatic
and come
fixing.
Okay, so you break a lot of glasses at home?
No.
No.
Especially a window glass, when it breaks off in the corner, then you just go, okay, robot, automatically fix that up and then lift it up.
Okay.
That'd be so easy.
That's interesting. Can one of you tell me, from where do you get all these ideas?
I can tell. From my brain.
Okay. Anywhere else? Do you see things or do you learn something, read something?
We can, like, see, suppose they have, suppose like you see cartoons, right? In that, if you find robots like this, then you get the idea from there also.
Okay, that's nice. So you see from television or something?
Yeah, like Doraemon and stuff, so.
Okay, yeah, Harshil?
And I usually see QtPi Robotics, the tutorials.
Mm-hmm.
So when I see one project and another project, so I try to combine them both.
Okay, can you give me any example? You did something like that? You tried?
Yeah, I've done. I've combined a smart tap and a smart scrubber.
Wow, and what do you do out of that?
That is only the smart water scrubber.
Wow, okay, that's interesting. Okay, do you like to watch movies?
Yeah.
Yes, I love.
Okay, which was that?
Frozen.
Okay, what do you like in that?
I like the ice that comes out from her hands.
Oh, okay. How about you?
I like Spider-Man Homecoming.
Oh, I love watching Spider-Man movies.
I don't know why these spider webs, when you touch the spider webs, he feels so light.
Yeah, okay, good.
I like Man of Steel, which is a man is made up of steel, which can punch. That's why I like punching movies, like some hero is coming and some villain is hitting him. So I want that a robot to come and punch him, he'll go flying.
Okay. No, I'm sure if you want to give a message to other children, okay, of any age group, what message do you like to give them?
I would like to give one. Children, I guess you should be really creative, which will help you do many things in life. Thank you. That's it I
want to
say.
Harshil, do you want to say something?
Yes. We should not give up. We should always think positive.
Oh, wow. From who is inspiring you to tell these nice, kind words? Amazing. Very great. Yeah, Neel. Are you thinking?
No.
Okay. No? Okay, be happy and be joyous.
Children, I'm only going to say one thing, that never give up, be positive and go for the work what you want to do.
Wow, amazing, good. Is there anything else you want to share about yourself?
No.
Do you want to talk anything about which you want to tell to listeners?
No. We need to think a lot on it then.
I need one day to think about it.
I just need 5 minutes,
okay? Okay. Listeners, till now we heard about how robotics is helping children from Harshil, Hasvika and Neel for STEM education series at Radioactive 90.4, Bangalore's first community radio station. We are closing session and would like to thank all those three wonderful kids.
Thank you, listeners, for listening.
Thanks for being at Radioactive CR 90.4.
Please dial 22355490, 22355490 for your suggestion and feedback. In case you missed listening to the talk, it is available at soundcloud.com, soundcloud.com. Be active and keep listening to Radioactive. Signing off, your RJ Santosh. Thank you.
Talk shows, lectures, documentaries, discussions, arguments, information, education, entertainment, infotainment, music, drama, theater, and more. Only on Radioactive 90.4 megahertz. Get active.